These soldiers are training for a new era of warfare.
One fought with drones of all shapes and sizes.
But some of these drones aren't like the others. They weren't shipped in from the mainland. They were designed, manufactured, and tested right here in Hawaii.
This is Lightning Labs at Schofield Barracks on the Hawaiian island of Oahu. This is the US Army's test site for 3D printing on demand. Soldiers here are designing, building, and tweaking drones from digital files, turning raw plastic into flying aircraft in a matter of hours.
In this case, they're producing FPV drones. First-person view aircraft flown by operators wearing goggles that show a live camera feed.
This is our, we're calling it the Kestrel drone, but it's a one-way attack drone. Essentially, it's a user-guided munition. We start with a 3D file, we get it into the printer, print it out, then we put all our components on, a flight controller, electronic speed controller, motors, and the radios, and the camera in the front. And then from there, we add all the stuff you see here on the bottom, which is called our fire set, which just allows us to configure explosives onto the drone.
Printing means soldiers can build FPV drones closer to the battlefield instead of waiting weeks for shipments across the Pacific. And each printed FPV drone costs a fraction of a conventionally manufactured one. The advantage isn't just speed, it's about survival. Recent conflicts have shown how easily supply lines can be disrupted. And nowhere is the challenge greater than the Pacific, where vast distances make resupply slow and vulnerable. In a conflict with China, those routes could face even more pressure from missile strikes, cyber attacks, or blockades. The Army hopes printing drones on site can make units more resilient. Out on East Range, a vast training ground on Oahu, the Army uses a mix of drones, each with a different job, to find and strike targets. Long-range fixed-wing systems like the P550 and Stalker scan wide areas. C-100 quadcopters move in to confirm what's there. And once the picture is clear, printed FPV drones take over to execute the attack.
So the drone that I'm operating tonight is called the C-100. It is a medium-range reconnaissance aircraft. We're gathering intel and data so that we can help our commander understand and know what's actually out there on the battlefield so he can make the best decisions.
Hagler's team builds the battlefield picture, confirming what's moving and where. Only then does the FPV unit prepare to strike. But before anyone commits, it falls to FPV operators to read the target and choose the safest, smartest way to strike.
So it just depends on the scenario, whether it's like, it's already been vetted. Yes, I can see it from far away that that's CSK-141 and I'm striking instantly, but maybe it's something I'm not too sure of, that maybe I need to encircle or do a little quick pass by to be able to then strike it.
Printing and adapting FPV drones at the edge of the battlefield flips the old model. Units make what they need when they need it, a tactic already seen in Ukraine.
That's a great advantage, is having something within your battalion or brigade to be able to produce something like that that's super cost effective and then being able to cause the destruction out there you see it causing.
In this demo, a printed FPV armed with explosives in a real conflict is guided by an operator along a set approach to hit a target. But printing the frame also lets soldiers swap in different tech modules. This version includes a system that enables coordinated swarm formations, multiple drones flying together, all controlled from a single laptop, which is exactly what this team is doing as they plan an attack.
Realistically, we're looking at about 900 meters.
Yeah.
And there's maybe 10, 20 meters of elevation change between here and here.
Being able to control the drones from a laptop enables the team to stay dug in and camouflaged.
The way that this is set up with our antenna, with our radio out there, we don't need to really be able to have surveillance. We can actually tuck ourselves in a little bit more. We don't need direct contact with the drones or visually, so we can really afford ourselves a little bit more of an opportunity to hide. I mean, that's the big thing is that counterfight right now of while we're finding the drones to find the enemy, the enemy's flying their drones to find us.
What's unfolding here is a step towards understanding how the edge of the battlefield can become a factory floor, and soldiers can become builders. In a region where distance is a constant disadvantage, that kind of agility may prove decisive.